Open the window. How many of you have done 16? Very good. Okay, so get done with this part. So it's something like this. There's a tube and there are some holes at the end of the tube. What's the area of, what's the diameter of tube? Is that given? Diameter of tube is 1 mm. Area of? Area of cross section is
8 centimeters.
Any meter square. Okay, fine. So that is area 1 here, this area. Okay? If it's too windy, you can shut it with it. No problem. But tau one number is. Okay, area is 8 centimeters square. Then, diameter of hole is given. What is the diameter of hole?
1 mm.
D2, 1 mm. Okay, and how many such holes are there? 40. Okay. Is speed over here given? 1.5 meter per minute. Okay. And what do we have to find? Speed of
ejection.
That is where I have to find out with how much speed the water will come out from the hole. So speed at one point given, area is given. The other area is given, and we have to find speed. So best way to solve it is equation of continuity. A1 V1 equals the value. So V2 is equal to A1. Area of the first place here is 8 centimeters square. 8 into 10 raised to minus 4. V1 is speed. It is 1.5 meter per minute. So we have to convert minute to second. So divided by 60, because 1 minute is 60 seconds. Divided by. A2 is divided. What is A2? 40. A whole no area into 40 got put in it. Does that make sense?
Yes.
Everybody, because there are 40 such holes from which fluid will come out simultaneously. Right? So diameter is given. Who remembers formula of area given diameter of circle? Raise your hand. If diameter is given, how to find area of circle? Simple question, 10 standard. If diameter is given, how to find area of circle? Okay, very good. What?
Pi r square.
Pi r square. So, what is
the
radius?
1/2.
Okay, fine. Sit down. Correct method. First, from diameter, you can find radius and then do pi r square. Or you can directly do pi d square by 4. Right? So, these are two valid ways to do it. Okay? But the value is no one is there. This is a certain way. I'm leaving that part to you. Okay? Well, so that is about the problem. Now I gave you one extra problem regarding two liquids with different densities. Have you done it?
Yes.
How many of you have done it? Very good. Right. Put your hand up. Princy, what's your answer? You have okay, sorry, sit down. What's your name?
My.
You are forum. What's her name?
Nisha.
Sorry, yeah. Nisha, stand up. What? Can you say that louder? Interesting. Okay. Just a minute. So it means that there are two liquids, am I correct?
Yes.
And above the hole, the first one had how much height?
Yes.
Okay. This is it. And then there was another liquid. So total height was 3h by 2. Alright, and this had density?
2 rho.
And this one had density?
3 rho.
Okay. So, Nisha, can you tell us what you have done? Rho 1 gh1 plus rho 2 gh2 is equal to half
rho
v square. Now, that's a curious kind of symbol. What is this rho?
Rho 1.
Rho 1. Very good. Because that's the fluid that is flowing out. Okay, so you just have to put the value in, right? Is that what you have done? Sit down. So the method is correct. But I'm not really sure we'll get this kind of answer. Let's check. So, rho 1 is 2 rho. GF. Pull up. Row 2 is 3 row. Is that okay? G. What the height that we should be taking for the second one? H by 2, because that fluid is only having a height of H by 2. Is equal to 1 by 2. Row 1 is 2 row, and we want to find out this P. So what I think what we do here, LCM the layers per se. So this will become 7 row GH by 2 is equal to 1 by 2. Okay, you could have cancel the 2's out, right? I'm going to cancel the 2's out. So this is it. V is equal to under root 7 GH by 2. Who gets this answer? Very good. 3.5, root of 3.5 GA. Probably you could put value of G as 10. Then you get root of 35. But that's fine. Yeah, that's fine. No problem. Okay. So we shall check where you made a mistake. Somewhere in the calculation. Alright, so that's it. Be a minute, no homework or two. I would hope next time everyone would have some answer. Right, wrong. That is for me to decide. Don't worry about it. Your job is to do it. If you did it wrong, I will correct you. Right? नहीं आवड़ तो ये मानी ने बेस्ट हो तो फिजिक्स नहीं आवड़े कारण कि फिजिक्स में जाने एक बहुत मोटा प्रॉब्लम है फिजिक्स नहीं थियरी है समझा मारते तो मैं न्यूमेरिकल सॉल्व करा पड़े पर न्यूमेरिकल सॉल्व करा मारते थियरी आवड़ भी चलो वे हमारी बाहर कहीं तो नहीं करो देर ओनली वन वे पहला न्यूमेरिकल थियरी थोड़ी समझी आवे ना तो न्यूमेरिकल ट्राई करो ना खोटा पड़ते હું તમને કહું છું ખોટા જ પડશે પણ એ થોડા ખોટા પડશે ને પછી તમને ખબર પડશે કે આમ કરાય ને આમ ન કરાય ધેન યુ વિલ બી એબલ ટુ અન્ડરસ્ટેન્ડ થિંગ્સ બેટર એવી રીતે થાય બધા ચેપ્ટર ઓકે વેલ દેટ વોઝ 60 નાઉ આઈ થિંક વી શુડ ગો ઓવર ટુ ધ નેક્સ્ટ ટોપિક વેન્ચરી મીટર મેં કરાવી દીધું હતું ને એન્ડ વી સોલ્ડ એક્ઝામ્પલ 10.7 હતો એમ આઈ રાઈટ ઓકે નાવ યુ સી ધેર ઇઝ અ થિયરી બેઝ ટોપિક રિગાર્ડિંગ બ્લડ ફ્લો હાર્ટ અટેક ડાયનેમિક લિફ્ટ ઓકે દેટ્સ અબાઉટ સ્પિન એન્ડ સ્વિંગ યુ નો ઇવન ઇન ફૂટબોલ ઓર ક્રિકેટ ધ બોલ સ્વિંગ્સ રાઈટ વેન ઇટ સ્પિનિંગ લાઈક ધીસ ઓર મે બી લાઈક ધીસ So all of that is explained over here, right? Along with that, there is also an explanation of how aircraft fly in words. In one single line, if I have to say why do all these things happen, I say Bernoulli is here, is what allows you to understand what's going on, right? But in different cases, it has some special name. For example, for, you know, balls going left, right, like that, it's called Magnus effect and all that, okay? All that is theory, you should read it. Like I have said, all of it depends on Bernoulli's theory. Right? No, some is a good idea. Don't be shy. Right? Next is viscosity. That also reminds me, today you will get an assignment for unit dimensions and errors. Right? Because we could not give you when that chapter was completed. Because at that time you were at home. Right? So, we will get it now. Question 13. Right? Let's begin. Question 13. Okay. Now, before we actually solve this one, there is a particular theory which is related to math, but I want to cover it. Right, you will study it in math in 12th standard. Too late for us. So first of all, I have to explain it to you. Then we can start with this 13th question. Right? It's not that big deal. We might have talked about it here and there sometimes in some chapter in physics. And this is it. I'm making it very clear. Maximum and minimum. Okay, using differentiation, finding maximum and minimum using difference. Okay, I will try to keep the math to as much minimum as possible. Jitlu kaam the itlu bol. Aapko chapter na samjhaun hamare. Right? Okay, that I leave for next month. Now, what do we have here? Suppose there is some graph of some quantity, let's say speed versus m, sorry, velocity versus m. The graph is like this. Do you realize at this point the velocity is maximum?
Yes.
Yes or no? Sure? Yes. Okay. Now if I will draw a tangent here at this point, the tangent is horizontal. So tangent slope is 0 at that point. Yes or no?
Yes.
Tangent slope is 0. At which point, at let's say this time. Suppose this is t equal to 2 seconds. This is equal to 2 seconds. The tangent slope is 0 at t equal to 2 seconds. Now, do you remember that if you draw a VT graph, what does the slope of tangent indicate?
Acceleration.
Very good. Slope of tangent is acceleration. So, do you agree that at t equal to 0, or sorry, at t equal to 2 seconds, sorry, acceleration, which is slope of tangent, is equal to
0?
Sure? This much clear? But do you also remember that acceleration is actually nothing but so I hope you are seeing a link. The link is that whenever some quantity becomes maximum, for example here at this point, what is maximum? Velocity or speed is maximum, right? Never. So at this point, its differentiation is equal to
0.
Now the same thing is true for minimum also. Let's say the graph further goes like this. So do you realize that over here, till that point the velocity was decreasing, 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 and then suddenly it started increasing. So here it should be minimum, yes or no?
Yes.
Same story again, tangent slope is 0 and once again acceleration is 0 and once again dv by dt is equal to
0.
So in short, what we have is that whenever something becomes a maximum or a minimum, both possibilities. Whenever something becomes a maximum or a minimum, its differentiation becomes
zero.
The differentiation is zero for that point. Okay, its differentiation becomes zero for that point. Okay, so here the differentiation is not zero. I hope you realize that. Here also it's not zero. But at whichever point it's going to become maximum or whichever point it's going to become minimum, at that point it's going to be
zero.
What's going to be zero? The difference. So if dv by dt is zero here and here, that means there you will get a maximum or a minimum. This is not 100% correct and, you know, not full detail. Like I said, I don't have to explain the whole thing. I'm only putting the basics in front of you. The details you are definitely going to study in math. But after physics, what to chance there? Right? Ultimately, we see the Javanat show final exam. So, we might go to tension level. Got it? So, we get dv by dt is equal to 0. Because v is maximum or minimum. When j maximum or minimum, then n difference is 0. Got it? Let's read this question. So this is true not just for velocity, for everything. Remember, for everything. So in the question, what is to be maximum or minimum? Did you read that question 13? Or you don't have it? Hey, what's the question? Maximum, minimum, no. Okay, nothing. Okay, sorry. I misunderstood that. 8 seconds, na? Ena pachino question. 13 and 14 are linked with each other, right? Never mind, it won't be useless, right? We will not use it in 13, we will use it in 14, right? I'll let it be here, okay? I'll let this be here, so that you can refer it when you solve that question. So 13, come on. 13 is straightforward, it doesn't use that idea. So, what does the question say?
It says a vessel, right?
It is placed on ground, correct? And then what's done?
Water
is filled up to a height, we take capital?
Yes.
Capital. Okay. Then what?
Hole at depth D.
There is a hole at depth D. From above. Let's say here. So this depth is D. Okay, then. What to do?
Express the
horizontal
distance is x in terms of
h. Okay, so figure shows that water will flow out like this initially at zero angle. I hope you understand, because the hole is vertical, so when water will flow out like that. Make sense? Sure. And I hope you can hear that projectile motion is approaching you. Samrajna Noval, projectile motion. Okay, na Samrajna. Okay, so it will fall here, and we have to find out what is this x. And then in the next question, we have to find out what can be this maximum. Right? So it's directly linked with it. Never mind. So here, we have to find range. Correct? But is this projectile starting from ground?
No.
So what to do? You need to use equation of Rayleigh. Clear? Sure. And after using equation of Rayleigh, let's say from the point A to the point B, what should we find? Which displacement do we have to find? Horizontal, vertical?
Horizontal.
Horizontal. That's called what? Delta
y.
X. Delta x. Clear? We have to find delta x from equation of trajectory. So first of all, let's write down equation of trajectory. You remember the equation of trajectory? Okay, baki pata kya yaad rakhna jo?
V0 tan theta 0 by V0 into delta x minus half g delta x square by V0 square cos square theta.
No, you made some mistake in the starting few terms, I believe. To left side to boil was nothing. Parvane, left side to our.
Delta y is equal to tan theta 0 into delta x minus.
Delta y equal to delta x into tan theta 0
minus
1 by 2
g delta x square.
Delta x whole square divided by
v0 square cos theta 0.
That's right. What's your name?
Jaikir.
Sorry, mistake. That's what. Right? Sit down. Well tried though. Everyone, high time that you remember projectile motion. Okay? So, this is delta y equal to delta x tan theta 0 minus 1 by 2 g delta x cos square upon v 0 square cos theta. I use karate. So, let's see which terms we know and which we don't. So, first of all, delta y from A to B. Remember, we are using this from A to B. How long money have we dropped? So, one the name. A to B, vertical displacement, how much? H minus D, wrong. Minus H minus, because we take upwards positive and downward negative. You might be thinking that we will give reference to upper negative lo to chale, niche positive lo to chale. I'd say no, because when you write this equation, you are already considering acceleration to be negative, that means you are taking downward negative. But you are desi badal, so the answer is what? Understood?
Yes.
Because you took minus here, minus g, that means you are taking downwards as negative. You can't change it. If you change it, this formula will become wrong. You'll have to change the formula. So negative of h minus d, is this clear? Again, suppose you think there is a point C here, a magnitude, but it is in which direction?
Down.
Clear, because the water falls down, not up. So negative equals. So where delta x?
Minus.
we want to find. Let it be like that. Okay, then tan theta 0. What is the initial angle of projection or throwing? At which angle will this come out?
Zero.
Understood? The tan 0 is how much? Tan 0 is? Next time હવે આટલો ધીમે થી વાજે આખા ક્લાસ એ ટેબલ લખવું પડે પાછો વોટ ઇઝ કે તમે મેથ સ્ટુડન્ટ છો તમને સાઈન કોસ ટેન ની વેલ્યુ તો મોઢે આવડતી હોય ને નો આવડે હું તો તમને સાઈન 72 ડિગ્રી પૂછવાનો હતો એક દિવસ જે મને નતો આવડતું રિયલી નોટ જોકિંગ બટ યુ સી યુ શુડ ડેફિનેટલી નો 0 30 45 60 એન્ડ 90 એન્ડ પ્રોબેબલી 120 150 ઓર રાઈટ એનાથી સ્પીડ વધે અને 90 સુધી તો આવડવું જ જોઈએ અધરવાઇઝ યુ આર સિટિંગ ઇન રોંગ ક્લાસ નો આવડતો હોય તો આજે જ વાંચી લેજો ઓકે એક્સ્ટ્રીમલી સિરિયસ બિઝનેસ ધેટ છે જમવાનું એનાથી ઓછું ઇમ્પોર્ટન્ટ છે લેટ મી ટેલ યુ ધેટ આવડવું જ જોઈએ મેથ્સને 0 ટુ 90 ની વેલ્યુ તો સો ડેલ્ટા ઇઝ ટેન 0 માઇનસ 1 બાય 2 G is 10. Are options in form of G? Nevertheless, cut thai jate. Bullet is G. Delta x squared, again we don't know. Divided by V0. How much is V0? V0 means initial speed when this water comes up. And it's okay, I'll name it. Speed of efflux. Is that okay, everyone? Speed of efflux. So, what's the speed of efflux? Under root 2gh upon 1 minus a squared by capital H. But areas are not given, and normally, if nothing is mentioned, we'll take the easy case. That is, it's a tiny. So, neglect or not, denominator 1. Okay, so what should I write here? Under root 2gh. Square, so only 2g. H, there's no h here. So look, what should I write here? 2gd, very clear. No, in a manually formula, need terms here. Who knows the term? Of Torricelli's law or speed of efflux. Okay, put your hands down. However, randomly put jene ne avde and lokush padte. Barabar badhu fight. Okay, because here we are at a critical juncture. All right. Okay. Say the terms of first. Say the Torricelli's law or the speed of efflux formula. Okay, now what are the terms?
G, gravity,
okay. Never mind. Can you tell me here what should we write in place of that H? D. So how would you express it in words? Here is hole, here is that surface.
Height of the hole from the upper surface?
I hope you realize it doesn't make sense. It is depth of the hole from the upper surface. Write the terms by that. Okay, don't write anything else. So, here we should have D. So, ekdam fluently terms how do you do it? So, var no lage jara. Clear? And again, I hope you all are realizing that if you remember those words, kanishku ky, then in Eigen we can easily decide what we are talking about. I hope you realize why I'm asking you to remember the term. Right? Otherwise you'll get confused. Like some of you did say H minus D here. Some of you did say H minus D. Wherever you go to 9, the correct is D, because that H in the formula is depth of the hole from the upper surface. Clear? Okay? So 2GD. Now cos, what do we write here? Cos squared? Cos squared? Okay. So let's simplify this. Minus of H minus D. Tan 0 is 0. GD cancelled. Isn't it? Okay, then delta x whole square x 2 and 8 and 4. Cos 0 is? Cos 1. Cos 0 1. What about that? સારું નો લાગે ને તમે એમ કહો કે મેથ્સ લીધું છે અને વેલ્યુઝ નથી આવડતી, તો એવું વધારે ટાઈમ રહેવા નહીં દેવાનું. આજે નથી આવડતું, નો પ્રોબ્લેમ, કાલે આવડી જવું જોઈએ. ઓકે, અને એમાં હેઝિટેશન ન જોઈએ. કોઈ એમ બધી વળી સાઇન 30 તો તમે બે વાર વિચારો અને પછી આન્સર આપો 1/2. આઈડ સે દેટ ઇઝ નોટ ગુડ, રાઈટ? સો ધીસ ઇઝ વોટ વી હેવ. સો ફાઇનલ આન્સર વિલ બી ડેલ્ટા ઇઝ ઇક્વલ
2 plus
D. Thank you for reminding. So delta x square is equal to 4. What is it? Multiplying over there. 4 into D into H minus D. So which option? Don't forget to take square root though. Clear? મને તમને છે ને વારે ઘડી આવે છે ડરાવવા ગમતાય નથી. મને એવું લાગે એટલું બધું નો ડરો, પણ શું કરો, ઘણી વાર તમે બેઝિક્સ ભૂલી જાઓ છો, દેટ ડઝન્ટ હેલ્પ. અને આન્સર આવડતો હોય તો બોલવાનું, મેં તમને પહેલા જ કીધું છે, બેઠું નહીં રહેવાનું. ઇટ્સ નોટ અ મૂવી દેટ યુ કેન નોટ શાઉટ. ઓકે, યુ ડોન્ટ જસ્ટ હેવ ટુ વોચ. સો ધીસ ઇઝ ધેટ ટાઈપ. નાવ લેટ ગો ટુ ધ નેક્સ્ટ પેજ. Question 14. I believe there will be some small variation, I don't know. A fixed cylindrical vessel is filled with water up to height h. Okay, this part is saying. A hole is bored, bored that is drilled in the wall at a depth h from the free surface. So instead of D now, what do we have? Okay. So immediately, if I want to change things, I can change it like this. You understood that? Where there was capital D, now we have H. Fine. Now what is the question? For maximum horizontal range, H will be equal to. So first of all, let's find out delta. Or you know, you can do it directly with delta x square also. See, we want to find the maximum possible value of this. So what did I tell you? Whenever something is to be maximum or minimum, its differentiation should become
zero.
Well, so temporarily, let's call it z. Okay, because you know, you don't want squares and delta and complicated. So let's call it z. So we want z to be maximum, because think of it. If some square is maximum, its square root is also maximum, isn't it? Make sense or not?
Yes,
yes. So we are going to find when is z maximum. If we find when is z maximum, we'll automatically get when is this range maximum. So for maximum range, we should have dz by d something. For example, input velocity, the differentiation of velocity with respect to time, that is dv by dt, was 0. See, you have to differentiate with something. You just can't write dz by d. So here, whatever you are writing should be a variable. You can only do differentiation with a variable. For example, writing this is absolutely nonsense. Okay, dy by d3 is ridiculous. What I mean to say is, this can't be a constant. Then it makes no sense. So here we have to write something that is going to change. read the question. What do you think could have different possible values? Read the question carefully. What do you think could have different possible values? Speed of f plus though, so you can dz by dv log. What do you think could have different possible values?
Small s,
that is right. See, what we are given is there is a vessel with some height, x, particularly, capital. Now we are free to drill a hole anywhere. Do you realize the meaning of the question? Everyone, read the question again. It says, the hole is bored at a depth x. We don't know what that is, right? And then what does the question say? For maximum horizontal range, what should be x? Make sense? That this h is variable. You understand what is a variable, right? This h is a variable. You are free to make a hole anywhere you like. But you have to do it so that this becomes maximum. So, kya karwan yo practical question. Hum jo dene the practical aspect hai, tumne samjha hai to. So, suppose you try to do it practically. Shu thai? Ek var karu maximum nahi aavti, haji dur karu de. Pachho niche karso, niche karso. You will waste a lot of time. Instead of that, use math. Math will tell you where to make that hole. So math kevi kevi vastu bodhi de tamara mane. You understand how good tool math is. Panch var drill karva kada ek var calculate karvanu ne ek j var drill karu. Isn't it? So we want to get maximum range and we know small h is variable. You can drill here anywhere, but h is going to change. So dz by dh is equal to 0. Who understood this line? Only then we can proceed if you understand that. Again, what did I tell you? For getting something maximum, its differentiation should become
0.
And like I said, differentiation can only be with respect to a variable. This change the way. So our question must change h as thai. This h only can change. Anything else cannot change. Clear? Sure? So, dz by dh is equal to, well, what to do now? Differentiate this. Pehla din I'll multiply karna. That way you'll find it easier. Do you remember the addition rule of differentiation? So, z is equal to 4hx minus h squared. 4hx, this is what z is. So now dz by dh is equal. And differentiation karan. One have day, raise your hand. Bani mehnat karai diyo differentiation mate. Saath aath questions hai pada practice karo. I hope everyone need it. Okay. Yes, Kevin. What do you think will be the differentiation of this?
4 capital H minus 8. 4 into 2 is 8. Or 8 1.
Only
sure. 2 minus 1
small
small.
Yeah, right, well done. Who understood this? Vichari na asu kare ho tumne formula puchi to nahi aavto hai. Who understood this? Again, keep your hand up everyone. Those who understood that. Okay. So there's still so many who didn't get it. अच्छा फॉर्मूला याद है डिफरेंशिएशन डी डी एक्स रेस टू एन बाय डी एक्स इज इक्वल टू आपको नहीं याद है रेज योर हैंड नाउ आई बिलीव इट शुड बी द सेम नंबर ऑफ पीपल बट आई एम स्टिल कंफर्मिंग ओके व्हाट इज इट एक्स रेस टू एन माइनस वन अपॉन टू वेयर इज द टू कम फ्रॉम n plus 1. No, you are mixing up two different formulas. It is d by dx of x raised to n is equal to n x raised to n minus 1. Right? Okay. You mix the one with integration together with this. Right? What's the name again?
Dia.
Dia. Okay, sit up. Dia. एक अजी वस्तु ऐड थी कि याद रखा
right? Please start working it up every day. બહુ બધું કરવાનું છે હજી પાછળ. બરાબર ને? એવું નથી કે મેં નતું કરાયું એટલે તમને ન આવ્યું, બટ પ્રોબેબલી યુ ફોરગોટ ઇટ, યુ ડિડન્ટ ટેક ઇટ વેરી સિરિયસલી એટ ધેટ ટાઈમ. એટલે હું તમને એક જ કહું છું, ઓનલાઈનમાં તમે જે ભણ્યા નહીં, તમે માનો છો કે તમને આવડતું હશે, ઇટ ઇઝ રોંગ, યુ ડોન્ટ નો ઇટ, લેટ મી ટેલ યુ ધેટ. એન્ડ યુ માઇટ બી થિંકિંગ ઇટ નોટ ધેટ ઇમ્પોર્ટન્ટ, ધેન યુ આર ટોટલી રોંગ. ઓકે, ઇટ ઇઝ એક્સ્ટ્રીમલી ઇમ્પોર્ટન્ટ. આ ચેપ્ટર નહીં ભણો ચાલશે, નેક્સ્ટ ચેપ્ટરમાં નહીં નડે. પહેલાનું નહીં આવડે ને તો આવીને બધી જગ્યાએ હેરાન કરશે દરેક સમમાં. બરાબર, આની પહેલાના સમમાં આ ક્યાં થયું હતું? રેન્જ ઓફ પ્રોજેક્ટ. પછી હવે આ ડિફરન્શિએશન નેડું. યુ સી વેર આઈ એમ ગોઈંગ? સો યુ હેવ ટુ ડુ ધેટ. એને પ્રાયોરિટી આપવી જ પડશે તમારે. ફ્લુઇડ મિકેનિક્સ નહીં કરો, નો પ્રોબ્લેમ, રાઈટ? ચેપ્ટર 2 to 6 મસ્ટ બી એબ્સોલ્યુટલી ક્લિયર. ઓકે, નેક્સ્ટ ક્વેશ્ચન, કમ ઓન. An incompressible fluid, liquid flows through a horizontal tube as shown in the figure. Okay. So there is a Y-shaped tube placed on the ground. Okay. Horizontal, this is top view. Then velocity V of the fluid is. Okay, where is that velocity V? Do you see there are three different pipes or three parts? First velocity 3 meters per second. Second one 1.5. Third one unknown. And areas are given. A1 is A. A2 is also A and A3 is 1.5. I apologize for the extremely tiny handwriting. Not handwriting, actually font. So, write the details. Come on, A1, A2, A3, V1, V2, V3. Out of all that, which one do we have to find? V3. Okay, and water is flowing. It's coming from where? From first one or? Look at the arrows. From first one, okay. Now, in this question, we are going to talk about a very simple aspect. Okay, think about this, everyone. If there is a pipe like this, okay, suppose in some time 3 liter water comes in, and in the same time 2 liter, okay, I'm not in a sorry, going to let's say it like this. Let's say from here 5 liter water comes in and 3 liter goes out like this. How much do you think should go here? 2 liter. Sure? Yes or no? Who understands that it should be 2? I thought it was common sense, right? Is it common sense like?
Yes.
Yes or no? In a physical language, my equation of continuity. Why? Whatever amount of fluid comes in should also go out because volume should remain constant. Cylinder move thai to jetu aa move thai jetu volume etlu volume aa aagal jau. At that time also I told you the same. So again, if this is 5 liter is not speed, mind well, it is volume. So 5 liter, if it's 3 liter, then this would be 2 liter. Got it? Just like that, if this is 5 liter and that is, let's say, 1 liter, then here it would be
4
liter. Absolutely clear. Okay, ek the law, I got told something confused. If this is 5 liter and this is 7 liter, then? If this is 5 liter and that is 7 liter, then?
Possible, okay.
I'm 2 liter. Is it not possible? Yes or no? Who understood this? 5 coming in, 2 coming in, so total going out 7. Basically, total incoming equal to total outgoing. Simple rule. Okay? Fine. So that's the equation of continuity. Now, what I want to specify, listen to this. is that I'm writing this as volume, but you can also write it as volume per unit time, right? Okay. In fact, that reminds me that I have to explain what is volume flow rate, but I forgot it. Am I right? Ek bola question for volume flow rate find karo na. Which question was that? 16 tha jo exercise number 16. Am I right? Do we have to find volume flow rate? Check the answer. Ek bar an answer check karo. And unit jo hai jab unit. What is the unit? Is it meter per second, meter per minute,
meter per second?
Okay, fine. Never mind. Then it's not important. So I take this time to explain what is volume flow. Listen to the table. Important definition. Okay, volume flow rate or rate of flow of volume. Volume flow rate means volume flowing per unit time. Volume flow rate means volume flowing per unit rate. See, तो तुम्हें समझ गया है. For something is called rate. Correct? It is our rate. Now, volume flowing per unit time. You can write it as V by T. Capital V.
Volume
by time. But then what? You know, little children write, we will write it like this. dV by dt, that is rate of change of volume per time, per unit. Okay, dV by dt. And if you realize that this dV by dt, it's actually nothing but, go back to where we derived equation of continuity. Do you realize there we wrote that a1x1 is equal to a2x2? Yes or no? a1x1 is a2x2. So a1x1 means how much volume it has moved forward. Right? So that is volume flow. And if you want to find volume flow rate, do you realize that I should just do it like this? How much volume it moves forward per unit time. Understood or not understood? Think of that diagram once again. If this has area A and this moves a distance x, right? So that much volume it has flown. If it has flown that much volume, then dv by dt. So this is going to be A into v, because dx by dt is v. A is a constant. You can put it clear?
Yes.
Okay. So what we are using in equation of continuity, A into V, that quantity is actually equal to volume flow rate. Understood? Again, volume flow rate means how much volume is flowing per unit time. Now let's quickly finish this question. Important, yeah? Yeah, that's good. Volume flow rate. Okay, what's the shape like? Left CMA, isn't it? Okay, yeah. Now here area is
A
and speed is
3 meters per second.
So that much volume flow is coming in. Now here it goes out. How much is that area?
A.
And speed is 1.5 meters per second. Excuse me, I'm writing wrong. Yeah. Over here, area is
1.5.
And speed is unknown. So use what I told you. Incoming equal to outgoing. So how much is incoming? 1, 2 or 3? Which one is incoming?
1
is incoming. How much is incoming volume flow rate? 3 into K. Yes or no? Yes or no? Sure. Now how much is outgoing? This is outgoing. So what should I write? 1.5 K. That is V2 K. Is there anything else that is outgoing? Is there anything else that is outgoing? Yes, which one? The third one? What should I write? Plus 1.5 A into
V,
which we don't know. Again, total incoming equal to total outgoing. Left, right. How is it for us? Very easy to do. What's captured? A is cancelled everywhere. Right? And then you can simply find out. Method clear. આવી રીતે ત્રણ નંબરે ચાર પાઇપ આવે તો આવડે ને ટુ ઇનકમિંગ એન્ડ ટુ આઉટગોઈંગ ઓર પોસિબલી થ્રી ઇનકમિંગ એન્ડ વન આઉટગોઈંગ હાઉએવર ધ કેસ ઇઝ ક્લિયર ઓર ટર્ન ધ વિડિયો ઓફ